This isn't going to time out correctly, but I'll let that roll for a little bit. We're done. Now then, I just basically need to do a lot of thanks before I naff off. And I'm not going to get round to a hundredth of the people that have been in contact with me. So if I don't get round to you, it's not because I don't love you, but I don't want to say thanks. It's just that it's impossible. So thanks, first of all, to all the poor producers and APs that have endured and enjoyed and cajoled and despaired, but mostly just joined in, giving their enthusiasm and their vision. Yes, I'm reading it. I haven't written a link in about 11 years, right? But I've written this one. Don't judge me. Helped us create a world. I'll miss some out, but I'm going to mention people like Mike Hansen, Serge Jean Baptiste, and James Stone, Jenny Smith, Louise Orchard, Nick, Nicholas, Phelps, Paul Sheehan, Johnny Raitt, Claire the Slev, Slevin, Dr. Adam, All the Bens, Joe, Haddo, Matt Tasker, Ali G, Mir De Parla, Alex, Bernard, Ash, Mark Higgins, Walks Like a Felled Tree, Lisa Kenlock. Must mention Ben Walker, the guy who got me in touch with the man who changed my career at the BBC, Nicholas Phelps, Simon Ward and Dermot, all the guys from upstairs, Jeremy, Ken Bruce, Steve Wright, Zoe, Jules, Bobby, Lynn Bowles was my sort of radio wife for a while, and everybody else up there, Rimshot, Julian Stockton and all the plugger guys, all the amazing Joes and James and Chris and Tina and Rajan and Steve Stone and Jane Arthie and Georgie Rogers and people like Sinead, who worked on the show, who just made me crease with laughter. Elizabeth Olker, the legendary Elizabeth Olker, all the news guys, Claire and Harve and Catherine and Nikki and James and Jason and Mike and Adam. How can I live not handing over to you three times a day? I don't know. Gary Bales, all the bloody bands and musicians. Jesus Christ, guys, you make our world such a beautiful place, and I can't start naming them because I'll leave everyone else out, but you've touched our lives so many times and you always will. People in the biz who've helped me, Greg James. And guess who, about 3 weeks after the news got out that I was leaving, guess who called me on the phone to talk to me whilst I was doing a pesto pasta for the kids? Steve Wright picked up the phone and checked that I was okay. That's unfortunately for you not the end of this link. It's just the end of the bed because I've not timed it right. Leslie Douglas and Paul Rogers and Helen Thomas. To Johnny Mole, get well soon. Callie and the Painter Man. To Steve Levine. To Lamo, my God, my hero. Riley, Radmack, Laura, Marianne, Jams, GP Worldwide. There should be a klaxon there, but I haven't got one. My family, it's a very big one, but especially my mum and dad and our kid and Sarah and Penny and Georgie and Orms, Debs, Tess and Lolly and the whole team, a nation of millions it took to bring me up. And it's their fault that I'm here. The nuts and bolts who keep the BBC what it is, the backroom guys, people like Emmons and Toby and Jules and the reception team who've just been amazing. They've been coming in through the pandemic and they've just always been lovely. We've just always had fantastic chats. To Z, to Zara, who's just one of the best, and has served with humility and difficult times. And then there's Phil, the wind beneath my wings. He's endured some wind over the years, I'll tell you that. More the less like the Lynn to my Alan, more like the George Martin to my Beatles. I am comparing myself to all the Beatles there. You're saying I've gone a bit Kanye. A man unmatched for enthusiasm, tact, gentility, sincerity, warmth, innovation and indie rock knowledge, 97 to 2009. He's not that tactile though, don't try and talk to him when the golf's on either. But in seriousness, I can't believe we're not going to work together. No, we're like brothers. You know, he's like the sort of brother that sorts everything out, and I'm the pinhead. He's one of the most pure-hearted people I know. He's a giant of a human who cares about everyone, never thinks of himself first. He loves radio almost as much as he loves golf, not quite as much as he loves Shelley, Minnie and Cody. Matt, we've done this before, but this is it now. One of my greatest ever friends, always there, thick and thin. I was the thick one, he was the thin one. Better or worse, richer or poorer. Am I proposing here? I don't know. funny, knowledgeable, connected. Elton, Macca, Janelle, pick up the phone, they'll talk to Matt. He's just simply the best at what he does. Nobody's better than him. His humility, his listening, his quiet wisdom. He gets too cocky after he's had a haircut. His elegance, his short fuse with taxi drivers. His family, Beth, BB, Joseph, Dave, Ellie, Ange, we're all so blessed to know you all. You've helped make Matt one of the best people in my life. I can't wait to see what you do and how you grow from here. My wife, love of every forthcoming incarnation of my life. The wisest, coolest, most beautiful woman I've ever met. Thank you. My three dependents, the most incredible things that I will ever see with my own eyes. The kids, you know who you are. It's all for you. And now then, the end bit, right? I think it's fair to say that when I was informed I wouldn't be doing this show anymore, I wasn't fully on board with the idea, to say the least. But since then, I've come to accept it as part of the ebb and flow and the tide of life. Casual dab surfers will be screaming at the radio, "It's just a radio show, you egomaniac! Get over it!" And it's partially true. I am an egomaniac. But those people who say it's just a radio show are wrong. It's not just a radio show. Any show like this isn't, really. It's a community. It's a fellowship. It's a very beautiful and inclusive club. And it's taken me nearly 15 years to work this out. For years, I got sad and angry. I felt like I wasn't living up to my potential, you know. Like, why can't I write a sitcom or an album or a novel? That's something that will live forever and stand the test of time. Radio's just ephemeral, right? It's just steam off your cup of tea. Well, you're wrong. It's a community, and we built this community together. Maybe an asylum would suit better, I don't know. I'm no fond of the community garden metaphor, and maybe I've lost the plot now, that's for sure. But you all popped in, you cleared the rubbish, you planted beautiful flowers, and now look at it. It's a verdant paradise, and I'm just a part of it, a tool, if you will. By accident or by perseverance, we've woven this sort of Bayeux tapestry, like an alternative little existence, you know. Like minds united in defiance of the ugly horrors of the world. It just sometimes is a horrible place to live, but we're united in kindness. We love daftness. We've got a love of music. We've got a disdain for over-seriousness and earnestness, a suspicion of authority, a need for honesty, but there's a thread of sincerity all the way through it. And in short, we here at Wogan House aim ultimately to be Woganerian. In the end, I got my wish. We have created something amazing, an irreplaceable thing that we must try to keep alive. A radio show is nothing without the enthusiasm and acceptance of its audience. It simply doesn't exist without that. That's why they're so hard to build. You can be as funny or innovative as you like, do as many great features as you want, but until the audience lets you in, you're just a silly tit acting daft. You gave this show life, and you gave it meaning, so it's not just a radio show. Your words and your time and your funny and silly sad emails in your heart, I'll always have it in my heart. Thanks for everything. I love you. I'm going to the pub now, and I'm not going to swear. And this is my showstopper, and this is what I want to leave you with, because it's the truth. We've only just begun, guys.